There is an African proverb. If you want to travel fast, travel alone. But if you want to travel far, travel together. And knowing something about you both, I think this is going to be a wonderful journey. And I know God will wish you every blessing and uphold you in all His love. Gabriel and Annabella, weddings always seem to excite people, and this wedding more than most. At the rehearsal last Wednesday night, I could see all the joy and excitement. Gabriel was here, meant to be practicing his promises, but he kept on sprinting to the back there to turn on the right piece of music and say, no, that's the wrong one. He was trying to control his groomsman like the captain of a football team, especially his best man who wouldn't stand still. His best man was more involved with trying to work out his dance moves. Meanwhile, Annabella was trying to work out how to get the groomsman and bridesmaids to dance up the aisle together.
So most of you guys know the story of how Annabella and Gabriel met. And let me just tell you, like, when Gabriel used to call me and talk about Annabella, I could sense his frustration over the phone. Like, I've always known Gabriel to be someone that never gives up on what he wants, and Annabella really made him work. So Gabriel told Annabella, "Would you be my Valentine?" And Annabella said no. So we were like, okay, this is gonna be a tough one, but I was honest with Gabriel and I said to him, just show her your heart, just show her how kind and honest you are and be transparent as possible. And on the 4th of June, 2013, right? Yeah, they started to go out, and I was so happy for Gabriel because I saw the amount of effort and time he spent into their first date, and I was just so happy because she made him happy.
You know when you iron the front of your shirt, did you guys just do that?
No, sorry. Did anyone go and get the buttonholes from Anna?
Oh, we met at university, and we met through a friend. It's one of my groomsmen, it's actually my best man. And he introduced us on my last day of university after an exam I had. And I went to, and she was working at a place called Ted Baker, and I went there to actually go and buy clothes for a holiday. I'm amazed by all your strength, and I'm grateful you come. I feel like God had a huge part of bringing us together. Like the fact that we both missed out on our first place university and ended up at Portsmouth University, and then just the way that we just happened just to have the same mutual friend. And then again, our world just interconnected and stuff like that. So yeah, I think God had a huge part.
No more. Oh,
I can tell that you've been praying. The day that I asked her out in kind of faith because she was going back to Leicester. But the next day, she had an interview and actually secured a job in London, which is such a big testament to the fact that we were always supposed to be together.
You know, I've stopped buying shirts with club mates because I can't deal with this anymore.
Gabriel had like little doubts about the future, like who he would become, what would happen in the future, who he would marry. But every time I spoke to him, I said, Gabriel, don't worry, because this guy's focus and determination is like beyond anything I've ever seen. But this is a determination I saw in this guy. And Annabella, I know what you're walking into, as I've said already, and he wouldn't let you go. Like, people go through divorces and stuff like that. I just know this ain't happening, because this guy's got God in his heart, and I know you've got God in your heart, so nothing else is going to change with you two.
Both of you have repeatedly told me that there are three people in your relationship. Don't worry. There is Gabriel, there's Annabella, but there's also a third and most important person of all, and that person is Jesus Christ. You two, in all your conversations, have never stopped putting Jesus Christ first and saying that God will be the center of your marriage. Hold on to that.
Follow we just thank you so much. Lord, we're here to celebrate Gabriel and Annabella's wedding, Lord. And right now, God, we just lift up them to you, Lord Jesus. We pray, Father, that today will be a blessed day, Father God. That, Lord, you take control of everything, every small detail, Father God, that they will both be relaxed and have peace in their hearts today, Lord God. As two become one today, Father God, we just lift them to you. We lift up their families. Lord, we lift up the whole day to you, Father. At the end of it, we honor you, Father God, and we put you first, Lord Jesus. I pray that we have an amazing day today, Father God, that, Lord, we just focus on having a good time and celebrating this wonderful couple. Amen. So, Father, have your way today in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Gabriel says this about Annabella. He says, she is a people's person. She has a really caring heart. She wants to make the world a better place, and she does. She has an enthusiasm for life. She is grounded in who she is. She's honest. She's exciting. She's really beautiful. In a moment, you're going to be sharing words with each other of great, great beauty. You're going to say to each other that you want to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death us do part, according to God's holy law. Those are big promises, as Gabriel would say. Those are big dreams, but no one could dream or hope for a greater thing.
When Annabella walked down the aisle, I'm just going to be like, finally, like, my wife is here. And it's something I've been waiting for such a long time.
I strive, we are healed. Eyes now pierced hands.
There could be no promise more wonderful to be making to the person you love than these promises. They are awesome promises, vows which take your breath away and rightly make you cry.
And the power of sin is broken. Yes, he did. He has won. Yes, he has.
lives. Sing. You have won it all. And we say death could not hold. Yeah. You're alive and well.
Hold in.
Stretch out your hands.
Love you, bro. Proud of you, man. So proud of you, fella. You got this. Come on. Proud of you, man. Come on, baby.
Stand up. This is your moment, man. You look at your wife now, and you look at her, Gabriel. You look at her, man. You look at her. Stand up, and you look at your wife. You look her in the eye.
Where a young man becomes very overwhelmed at the sight of his bride-to-be walking down the aisle has gone phenomenally viral. Gabriel and Annabella's entrance really tugs on the heartstrings, and we'll find out exactly why Gabriel was so emotional. I think we need to find out from the couple.
You know, I actually came into this wedding saying, you know, I'm not going to cry. Like, I was like, me, you know, I haven't put a bet on my mum, like, I think I've lost that bet, and I think I now owe you £50, don't I? Yeah. But yeah, I just felt so overwhelmed because, like, anyone who knows Anna just knows how good she, like. You know, at the time where I met Annabella, I was like, you know, she's a beautiful girl, she has amazing personality, but I was at that point where I actually just gave up on this whole love thing, because I thought it was just something that you just see in the movies, and I didn't even believe in that true love actually exists until I met her, and she's actually changed me.
It actually changed me to believe that. so good. She actually proved to me what true love is, and it's not just the, you know, calling on the phone saying love you babe, and then, no, now you hang up, and now you hang up. It's actually having like that sacrificial love towards each other.
All those who have come to support Gabriel, I want you to give him a loud cheer, to give him courage and to give him the love of God. Those who are supporting Gabriel, give him a loud cheer now. All those who have come to support Annabella, put your hands together and give her a good shout too.
Set the bar this high, so I'd like to say thank you for making my life hell. My girlfriend, who by the way looks absolutely stunning tonight, Sarah, she knows who she is, but anyway, all the time, Gabriel does this, Gabriel does this. Like, Jesus, like, that's what, all the time, and it's always like, well, Gabriel did this, and I'm like, look at this, I mean, look around, look at the effort that went in this evening, it's incredible. So I'd like to say thank you, Gabriel, for just making every guy in this room struggle now, because they will never live up to this.
I, Gabriel.
I, Gabriel.
Take you, Annabella.
Take you, Annabella.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
Say that one more time.
Till death us do part.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I make this vow.
I make this vow.
And now Annabella takes your hands. I, Annabella.
I, Annabella.
Take you, Gabriel.
Take you, Gabriel.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
To death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
In the presence of God.
in the presence of God.
I make this vow.
I make this vow.
Annabella,
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And now you place the ring upon her finger. Gabriel, I give you this ring.
Gabriel, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Well, my wife and I, yeah, my wife. My wife and I would like to thank you all for joining us. And the reason we wanted to have such a big wedding was because we realized that for us to be able to grow close together, we need all of you involved.
In the morning, when I wake up, and I will sing my praise unto you, my Lord. And I will shout, I will dance to you, for you have been my help from now to never. Let me hear you scream.
Gabriel, you are a lucky man. You are very, very, very lucky man. You are very, 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 very lucky man. Come on, come on, come on. Make sure Gabriel Deku, that you take care of Annabella Deku. She's a precious jewel that God has given you. And you know what you do with jewels? You guard them and you treasure them and you make sure they don't get, you know dusty. So you ain't get Annabella, don't worry, you're not getting dusty.
Everything that we said today and in the service, where it says for better or worse, I'm there for you, babe. You know, I'm rich. You know, if we don't have the money, I'm willing to eat those Jacob crackers, babe. Like,
of one thing I am certain, these two are greatly loved and really love one another. Just look at the joy here today in this church. And outside the church too, and in your cheers and shouts for them both, and in the smiles on everybody's faces, and in your wonderful little bridesmaids and flower girls, everybody. Why is this? Because in a good marriage, we glimpse the love of God. Thank you. disciples great. Love completes them in a way that only love is able to. So that together, you're more than just two people. You're 100 people.
Grateful that your relationship is the way it is, and I think everyone can attest to the fact that your relationship is so open and so transparent, and like Raquel said, you're such a good example to the rest of us. And so I just pray that God just gives you, grants you just all the desires of your heart, because you really, really, really deserve it. And yeah, like everybody said, looking forward to some little day keys running around, and looking forward to getting a key to your new house so I can stay over. And yeah, I just pray that God blesses you, because you deserve it so, so much. And I love both of you so much. Love you.
Gabriel Deku. Oh, it's not just Gabriel Deku anymore, is it? Oh, the Dekus. Oh, the Dekus.
That God just continue to bless your union, continue to bless your family. And guys, just promise me that you'll always be this fun, loving couple. Don't let anybody change you. You're the greatest, just the way that you are. And I can see God's light through both of you, and that's an amazing thing to have. What you're doing is so amazing. I look up to you both, and I just want to say thank you for showing me what true love is, and I love the both of you from the bottom of my heart. Thank you.
So my body don't lose, yeah. Now I pull my Shake body. Love is blind, but I didn't see her for your eyes. Oh, oh, oh.
my love, baby.
In Christian scripture, the love you are called to live is a reflection of Jesus Christ, the God of surprises. And in English, that love is translated in a number of different ways, from the Hebrew hesed, or from the Greek agape. It is faithful love, unconditional love, steadfast love, love which grows with you, love which, as Shakespeare said, does not alter when it alteration finds.
I just want to thank you for, even when I don't really know how, you know, where I'm going or how I do what I do, you're just always there to encourage and support me. And because of you, I feel like the best days ahead. And all the dreams that I had when I was a young boy, I feel like I'm now going to be able to fulfill them because you're right by my side. And for that, I thank you for everything.
For real love will mean that you will bear each other's struggles and pains and joys and losses. It's not something static or something which is just signed or sealed today. It begins today and it will last every minute of your life until you shut your eyes to make that journey to live with the author of all love.
I pray that you do love me.
Yes, I pray that you do.